Hello and welcome back, this is Tactical Soldier and today we are comparing two of the biggest smartphones to the test, Apple's latest iPhone XS Max and the Samsung Galaxy Note 9. Which of these will take home the crown? Watch till the end to find out. Display. Apple's iPhone XS Max has an OLED panel delivering 2436 by 1125 pixels, and the display also has Apple's True Tone color, and the contrast ratio is million to one, and it also has Dolby Vision and it is HDR10 compliant. On the other hand, Samsung's Galaxy Note 9 has a Super AMOLED with Samsung's signature Infinity display. It delivers a resolution of 2960 by 1440 WQHD plus, and it's also HDR10 compliant, and it's not as lurid as previous Super AMOLEDs though, but anyways, it is crispy and clear and vivid and brighter than Apple's display. Design. Apple's iPhone XS Max is not that different from last year's iPhone X, but it's significantly bigger at 6.5 inches while the last year's iPhone X was at 5.8 inches. Yet it retains the proportions and design of its smaller predecessor with stereo speakers but no headphone jack. But the iPhone XS Max is IP68 rated. Apple says this can go up to 2 meters for 30 minutes. Switching over to the Galaxy Note 9, it is comparatively bulky. Its display is a little smaller at 6.4 inches compared to the iPhone's, but somehow manages to look bigger than the iPhone. Just like the iPhone, the Note 9 is IP68 rated, but the Note 9 still has the headphone jack. The iPhone XS Max doesn't support the Apple Pencil, but the Note 9 has the signature S Pen that now functions as a remote too. Processor and storage. Apple's iPhone XS Max comes with Apple's latest A12 Bionic chip. Apple claims a 15% performance boost and 40% lower power drain in the performance cores and 50% less power drain in the energy efficient cores. The Apple-designed GPU runs 50% faster than the one in the A11, and its neural engine has 8 cores, not 2. App launches are claimed 30% faster than the Core ML machine learning framework run. The Core ML machine learning framework runs 9 times more quickly. The Samsung's Note 9 comes in 2 flavors in the US. And China, it's powered by an octa-core Snapdragon 845 with Adreno 630 GPU, while in the rest of the world, it's an octa-core Exynos 9810 with a Mali G72 GPU. There's 6GB of RAM on the 128GB model, or 8GB of RAM in the 512GB model. As far as storage goes, the base model of the iPhone X is 64GB that starts off with $1,099, but the base storage for the Galaxy Note 9 is a 128GB that starts at $999, and the Note 9 has SD card expansion and the maximum capacity that you can spec this out is 512GB on both the iPhone X and the Note 9. Moving on to cameras, the iPhone XS Max A12 Bionic processor enables the familiar 12MP dual lens setup to deliver better photos than the iPhone X. It delivers improved face and body detection and scene analysis, as well as better portrait shoots. In the most eye-catching feature, it enables you to change the depth of field after you've taken your shot. Smart HDR uses 4-frame buffer to capture the right shot with what feels like zero shutter lag. It also takes simultaneously higher and longer exposure shots to capture highlights and shadows. Those multiple shots are then automatically combined into a single image. The Galaxy Note 9 has a 12-megapixel super-speed dual-pixel dual-lens setup capable of f1.5 for great low-light shooting. It also has a clever noise reduction algorithm that combines multi-photo to identify and remove unwanted image noise, and claims it's impossible to take a bad photo thanks to artificial intelligence. It also shoots 4K 60fps, both iPhone X and the Note 9 is capable of this, and also the Note 9 can shoot 1080p at 240fps and a super slow motion that delivers a whopping 960 frames per second at 720p. Battery. In regards to software, the iPhone XS Max operates on iOS 12, which isn't dramatically different from iOS 11. Namely, notifications, parental control, and battery management are some things that are improved and some things are new in iOS 12. There's a brand new augmented reality measuring app that people are already using to measure their pets, and rebranded workflow app, now named Shortcuts, might just make Siri interesting again. But most of the changes that are in iOS 12 is under the hood, like refining performance and making it more stable. The Galaxy Note 9 software is Android 8.1 with Samsung's own Samsung Experience UI on top. It also has Bixby Personal Digital Assistant, which delivers live translation, food, calories, information, and information about the places near you. But the main difference in software-wise is the integration of the S Pen, which is now a clicker and a shutter button as well as a stylus. Overall, the Apple iPhone XS Max and Samsung Galaxy Note 9 have their strengths and also weaknesses. Two, Samsung's screen is brighter than the Apple's, while the Apple A12 Bionic is way faster than both the Snapdragon 845 and the Exynos 9810 SoC. So the ultimate choice comes down to personal preferences and what you want in a smartphone. Hence the final choice I will give to you guys to decide in the comments down below.